Hi there, Serial Trader here. Let's check in with CGC as it appears to have finally broken out of its three-wave very, very deep decline we had. It was an over 50% decline from the all-time highs, and labeling that as possibly ABC down for a very large degree wave two after having put in that initial very large degree wave one top up there at back in October at, let's see here, 59.25 was the all-time high. So we appear we have a nice tradable bottom here at 25.26. So that's pretty significant going from 59.25 to 25.26. That's a bloodbath for most people. And there's a lot of people that got sucked into the hype near the top. So even now after this initial move off the bottom, they are a long ways from seeing green, and they're still holding that bag real hard. Okay, that being said, let's examine the price action here since we had the bottom. So on at least a shorter term basis, we've broken several initial resistance levels. That was one around 34. Next one was around 35. There was also this gap to fill over here, which was around 38, 39. So we've done all that in a matter of three trading sessions. So that's it's funny how this stock behaves. Sometimes it does nothing for weeks and months, and then all of a sudden does more in literally a few days than it did in the previous few weeks or months. Just the nature of it. It's a very spiky kind of emotional stock, fear of missing out, and then absolute dread when it's going down and back and forth. It's just the way it behaves, but can offer some pretty good opportunity here. And you can see volume picking up strongly from where we had been. Volume just went dead as we were grinding lower, and now clearly some big money coming in here. So I like that this is likely a low that should hold for a significant period of time. All right, so we did also have this little bullish engulfing over here. That was on the 2nd of January, and then we had some consolidation after that, but the low of the bullish engulfing held, leaving it a valid signal, and then obviously we've taken off actually significantly from there. Okay, at this point we're well above the daily T line, so I'll pull back down to that area. Seems due soon. We got back above the long-term uptrend line. This green trend line was a nice uptrend line. Certainly tested it before, but here we broke it even more decisively. But now we're back above it, so that's positive. Daily RSI right around 70, so just in the overbought condition here after being not so long ago in the oversold condition around 30. So we went from being oversold on the daily on the 21st of December to now overbought on the 11th of January. So that's a pretty significant change there. So we've gotten above that bear market resistance level on RSI, which is between 50 and 60. So I like that we've broken out of that. Possible Doji star here on Friday, potential reversal in the overbought condition, and certainly looking for consolidation for the next kind of entry. Now, I personally used this big move up, and I certainly didn't sell at the top, but I used this big move up to get out of what was, in retrospect, not the best entry that I made over here, somewhere in the 33s. So I was stuck down here for a while, although I did put that hedge on with the sold calls and long puts. I took the hedge off, made a little bit of money on that, and left the long stock in play, and then seized the opportunity to get out in the green on the stock. And now I'm actually just in cash as far as this name goes, and looking for some sort of corrective decline for the next entry, because right now it looks on a short-term basis pretty overheated. So just to reiterate, daily slightly overbought now, 4 hour. RSI very overbought. We got as high as 81, 82 on that. So 4 hour RSI very much needs to cool off here. Hourly RSI, and actually we have a bearish divergence in hourly RSI. So we got as high as 91 on hourly RSI over here, and you can see we've certainly made a higher high in price and a clear lower high. Lower high in RSI. So we do have that bearish divergence on hourly RSI, so that it's a bit of an indication that at least some short-term consolidation is coming. Just back to the daily there. As far as the wave count goes, maybe we'll throw it on 4 hour and just give it a shot. So, obviously, some sort of one up, two down, and then obviously some sort of third wave, expecting a fourth and a fifth. This is kind of what I'm working here. Yeah, minute. Minor is too large of a degree. Minute works. So within wave three, we also have a one, two. One, two, three, four, five, four, five. So maybe we have a couple degrees of trend kicking off here. But just to keep it simple, we got definitely a one, two, three in progress. Possibly done, at least on a smaller degree wave three, looking for some sort of healthy wave four pullback. And then maybe another wave up to finish the initial impulse wave off the bottom, right? So maybe we're working something like this. One up, two down. Just put those out there here. Minor. And get these ones out of the way. Just set them aside. So yeah, kind of something like this. I think we're working here. So it's looking nice, looking impulsive. Definitely watching this one for another kind of three-wave looking decline for a good entry, and possibly go bigger on this one. But it just looks like it's due for a pullback here on a shorter term basis. That's probably good for this chart here. Just head over that Thinkorswim candlestick chart here to wrap it up. So yeah, definitely possible doji star reversal. Nice long upper shadow there on Friday. Obviously in the overbought condition here on the daily oscillator. Well above the daily T line, so that should come down, at least touch the T line here in a nice uptrend. And we were just starting to get below the 200-day moving average with the 50. Slight little death cross, but looks like that's going to get canceled out here pretty soon. Kind of a false death cross, if you will. And that long-term uptrend line, we're back above that again. So overall, looking nice. Volume coming in. I like that we do have finally a bottom to work from. But shorter term, looks like we need to have a little bit of cooling off, a little consolidation. And that should lead to a nice entry for another, trending wave up. Let's see here. So that's the daily. Anything remarkable on the weekly candlestick chart? Yeah, fairly significant. We got back above the weekly T line, which we'd close below basically ever since the week where we made the all-time high. In subsequent weeks after that, we just couldn't get back above that weekly T line. So we've done that pretty decisively. Obviously, that weekly volume coming in, significant. So definitely looks like a resumption of that larger multi-year uptrend. Just the initial move off the bottom for that. Anything monthly we can look at here worth looking at? So a monthly candlestick chart. Month's not over yet, but currently working a monthly bullish engulfing candlestick. Engulfing two prior months currently, but of course we have to close the month to see what we actually got here for a signal, and currently back up above the monthly T line as well, so that's also worth noting. So currently this is looking good, even though overall market expectations broadly are tend to be on the bearish side, doesn't mean you can't find some bullish charts out there, and this certainly appears to be a good one. So I'm definitely eyeing CGC up for another entry on a nice corrective pattern, but here looks like we're overheated short term and ready to come back in, and especially if the overall market's about to have another nice down leg to it, this name's likely to get dragged down a little bit with it. Although we're looking for that low to hold, even if the overall market makes new lows, definitely looking for CGC to hold its low there at 25.26. All right, we'll check in again on this name if something compelling shows up on the chart. Cyril Trader signing off.